Hello and welcome to the Birst How-To series. In this episode, I will be connecting to a database using a JDBC driver and the Birst Cloud Agent. There are a few things to take into consideration when connecting to databases and data lakes. First, your database connection will require the database type, database name, and login credentials. Each database connection has its own connectivity requirements depending on the vendor. You will need to download the JDBC driver for your data source and place it in the Birst Cloud Agent drivers directory. Birst will supply the driver for Microsoft SQL Server. In addition, you will need to download and run the Birst Cloud Agent when making connections to on-premise databases. There's a video on the Birst Cloud Agent installation in our video library, and agentless connections are available for cloud-based data sources. Let's take a look at how it's all done. Creating the connection starts from an enterprise or professional space. Once the space has been created, we go to Modeler and Connect tab. The connection can be created in two different ways. You can click on the plus sign on the left side of the screen or use the icons on the right side. You can change the connection type from the drop-down menu on the top. We will continue with the SQL databases. Then you give the connection a name. Choose whether you are importing to Birst or using Live Access. Next up is the agent selection. If you have a cloud database, you can skip the agent by using the slider. We are using an agent this time. Use the Show Online Agents Only button to get the list of active online agents. My agent is on the top of the list, so we'll go with that. Next, you'll choose the database type from the drop-down list. As mentioned before, for Microsoft SQL Server, the JDBC driver comes with the product. For the rest of the sources, you have to download the driver yourself. We are using Microsoft SQL Server. Next, you'll type in the name of the server where your database is located, the name of the database, the username, and password. Login credentials, that is. And then last, there's more options on the bottom of the page. What options we have depends on your database type. I will be using the source prefix. And I do this for two reasons. Number one, using the prefix makes it possible to see immediately what database I'm dealing with. And number two, if I have the same name table in two different sources, this way they don't get mixed up or written over. So once everything is done, we save the connection and connect to the data source. Once the connection has been created, the next step is choosing our schema. We'll go with DBO, and then we see the tables in our database. We'll do two imports here. First is a table import from the accounts table. We see a preview of the data, and if we want to not bring a column in, we can simply uncheck it. So the NetSuite customer ID is something we don't need. I will also filter the segment column. So we don't want the SMB lines of data to be brought in with this. I'll apply, and then Birst will show me a preview of the data we've chosen to import. So the columns are in light blue, and then we have the filter on top. The other way of bringing in data is using a query-based object. For this one, we will be using the same table, but this time we will bring in only the lines with SMB in the segment column. So I'll write a really simple select statement. We'll bring in all the columns from the table accounts where the segment equals SMB. I will then save the statement, and now we have the two imports we have prepared. Accounts as a table import, SMB accounts as a query-based object. I clicked on SMB account to see the preview of the data, and as you can see, the segment column only has the lines with SMB in it. So let's do the import. Once the import is complete, we go to the prepare page. In here, we can see our imported data sources. They're both grayed out, meaning that they are in ignored state. We can still take a look at the preview of the actual data. Once again, for the accounts, we can see that in the segment, the SMB lines are missing. And for SMB accounts, SMB is the only thing we see in the segment column. And that's how you import data from a database, from a JDBC source, into Birst. Thank you for watching.